So God showed me this vision, not sitting down writing an article. This is not press conference. This is a vision I saw, carry your youth along. I'm seeing a revolution. When I say revolution, I mean every revolution starts by protest. When it starts by protest, at that protest, the power can stop them. They have the ability to stop them. But when it becomes revolution, no one can stop revolution. Revolution means everyone is ready to go for it. I repeat again. I'm seeing what? A revolution. I'm seeing people taking to the streets. At the beginning of that protest, instead of revolution, I said protest is a parable. Yeah, because when it started, you think it's a protest. But at the end of the day, you realize that this is a revolution. You can stop protest, but you cannot stop revolution. You know, every revolution starts by protest. If I'm talking, let me see your hand. It will come, people carry planka. Hey. You say, this is protest. You carry police, you carry everything, you stop them. But when it becomes revolution, everybody are ready to die. So you can't stop it. At the beginning of that protest, I call it beginning because at the beginning of every revolution, it looked like protest. It might be stopped at the beginning. Eventually, it will become so big that it cannot be stopped. This I see happen. Nigeria, pray. God has given us the way out. Listen to the way out. The way out, are you there? Job creation. For the youth, and the creation of a new social value system. No matter the education the youth have, whether PhD or professor, youth, they feel they have no place in politics and there is no job to keep them busy. There must be a new orientation. In politics, the youth should be considered for important position such as assistant to elders. While the elders are ministers, the youth should be junior ministers. In all appointments into department of politics or administration, youth should be considered as well second in command. By doing this, we are training them to take over tomorrow. This is because they are leaders tomorrow. This is because revolution is a weapon of change that is coming. Revolution is a weapon of change that is coming. This is a vision. I'm not preach and I'm not teach. This is what I saw. This is the vision I saw. Revolution is coming when people will take to the street because life has no value anymore to the people. Carry your youth along in your politics and administration, especially in ruling your country. I have said it, none of this will go without being fulfilled. I have said it, none of this will go without being what? Read about me and my track record. This is the voice of God. When we carry the youth along, whenever there is a revolt or situation, they will be available to readily speak to their colleagues. Because people that are going for revolution or protest, 90% of them are youth. And they would like to hear the voice of their colleague better than anybody talking to them. If the junior minister come out, or junior chairman come out to talk to the protester, and they know it's a junior chairman, is there to represent them, they will listen to him better than anyone. The youth want to see themselves represented in every area of life. That is the answer to the problem coming. The coming ominous sign is disastrous. As sure as God lives, I, T.B. Joshua, will tell you only what God says. If I'm hated, if I'm persecuted, intimidated because of my accurate prophetic utterances, blessed be to God who gives the prophecy. The day will declare who is in the right and who is in the wrong, says the Lord.
Welcome to What Matters with Splendid.
In times for nations, and I've been repeatedly hearing from God, not only now, but over the past few years, and one more time it's coming before me, is the season is now coming for the continent of Africa. So Africa will rise up as a mighty army, because you are the last of the downtrodden kind. You were heavily trampled down upon. You have become the laughing stock of the whole world, especially the Western world. You were sold as slaves, you were robbed, you were enslaved, you were killed in massacred large numbers, the blood of the martyrs, the innocents, all crying out from the land. And the time of God's visitation for Africa is coming very soon, very soon. So let the saints of Africa arise and prepare yourselves to fasting, to prayer. You know, the new Rosh Hashanah is coming very soon, right? So I suggest to you, if you can fast for, no, this is just a suggestion, okay? It's not a word from the Lord. From August the 9th, if you begin a 40-day fast, beginning from August the 9th, it will finish just a day before Rosh Hashanah. You position yourself for something new that will be released from that. I see many, many chariots get ready to be sent to the continent to prepare a mighty move for God.
Hello Nigeria, my name is Tomi Arayomi and I just want to wish you a happy birthday, happy Independence Day. You know, I normally release a word of the Lord at the beginning of each new year, and I want to speak what God is saying over Nigeria. Do you know what's so amazing this time round? On this birthday of this festive occasion of Nigeria, we decided that we were going to pull together some of our best prophets in training in Nigeria to release this new release of a word of the Lord just after Rosh Hashanah, just into your 60th birthday. The first thing I want to highlight for Nigeria is a place of common consensus in the prophetic that most, if not all, of these prophets mention. Nigeria, you are in a pregnant season and you are getting ready to give birth. And even though the birthing process may seem long, there is a birth that is promised. But before birth, there's always birth pangs. Take a look at this.
I believe God is speaking of Nigeria right now and saying, you are a pregnant lady ready to give birth.
This great move of God will be preceded by a great birth pain.
For my name's sake and for the sake of the continent, 2021 will mark the beginning of the alignment of my plans for Nigeria and the birth of her destiny to be fulfilled. For while 2020 was the season of birth pangs, 2021 shall signal the season of birthing.
Wow. What was also amazing to me was that these prophets in training took particular time to witness over our youth.
The younger generation are about to take a position, take seats in positions of leadership. Now, this is not political leadership. This is leadership in businesses, leadership in media, leadership in ministry.
The Lord says that in 2021, There will be an increase in youth development camps, youth leadership camps, technological camps, and just an arising of youth platforms. Pay attention to education, says the Lord. Pay attention to university associations and things that are going on there. Provide alternative leadership platforms in universities. For indeed, I am going to use the youth in this era. And I'm going to bring about rising and increase of youth platforms. These platforms will become movements that are critical to the general elections, to the next general elections.
But most importantly, dwell in the mountains of education and family. Nigeria, hear this word. Homeschooling like never before will become the norm. And we, the kingdom mandates, we, the kingdom children, we will love Nigeria, even if you don't necessarily push it out there to be super religious. Those who love Nigeria will cause a new wave of understanding and teaching in the education and mountains of influence of family. Because Nigeria, it is your time to re-educate your siblings. It's your time to re-educate your family members. It's your time to re-educate your children on the ethics that Nigeria was created on.
I see a rising army of young people, the Jehu Company. I see a rising army of them that have hitherto been in the employment of the wicked ones concerning Nigeria, rise up to collaborate with the Jehu Company to throw down Jezebel in Nigeria and to restore righteousness.
The Lord says that in 2021, light will be shone on the youth in Nigeria.
He is going to bring people from near and wide. They're going to say, how is he so young and an apostle? How is she so young and prophesying? But the Lord is saying that because some of the forefathers refused to allow their mantles to be transferred to others, what the Lord is going to do is he's going to blow a fresh anointing on the generations that are rising, because they're going to carry out his agenda.
Thirdly, there was common consensus in the prophets that God was birthing a revival in this new season, especially again among the next generation.
God says, put me first in all things, Nigeria, for revival is coming to you. God is about to revive Nigeria politically, economically, and spiritually.
The Lord says, I will cause a revival in Lekki. I know that we have heard a number of times that the revival in Lekki is coming. However, the emphasis in 2021 is that 2021 will be the year of the washing. For the Lord says that I will send my flood and I will wash. I will take away the debris and I will raise my sons, whose very shadow will bring healing to the sick and raise the lame men.
I just heard the Lord say a revival is about to hit this generation, the Joshua generation, and will cause them to see the Father's heart, will cause them to see the love of God himself like never before.
And here's a word that we're not all used to, but guess what? With mercy, there is judgment. And we are getting ready to see a God rise up to judge a nation. Why? For the sake of producing righteousness.
God is going to pull down the altars and strong men that have entrenched themselves and have been taking advantage of the country in these sectors.
2021 will also bring about the unveiling of the men who stand in the dark to sponsor the slaughter of the people of the Middle Belt. There shall be no hiding place for them, for I will cause those who know to open their mouths wide like a running river, which will not be shut until their exposure is complete. Not only will the exposure come, but I shall cause them to be judged openly before the world for internal exposure and international investigation that will produce results.
You know, what was also interesting among these prophets, many if not all of them mentioned that in 2020 there was a shaking, but in 2021 the shaking will continue. And I love a scripture one of the prophets in training gave about how the shaking is that which can be moved will be moved, according to the book of Hebrews. Take a look at this.
Nigeria in 2021, prepare for a shaking. 2021 is the laying of the foundation for a different future, one yet unseen by the eyes of the people. For the nation may look like a shambles, but within the confusion, Nigeria will see my hand as I gather the pieces of the nation that I remold in my image.
Nigeria, you will experience more shakings, says the Lord, particularly in the first quarter. For the Lord says, I am purging the nation. especially in the leadership, political leadership, in the judiciary, in the business world, and in my church, says the Lord.
The Spirit of the Lord says, 2020 was a year of shaking, where everything as we know it has been shaken, so that what cannot be shaken will remain. In the year 2021, there will be more shaking, but the Spirit of the Lord says, it is a year of separation and sanctification.
Another place of common consensus was that God was raising up a new generation of nameless, faceless ones, and these will be a mover and a shaker of people who won't just operate in pulpit ministry, but they'll move into the different areas.
If you want to receive salvation, or you want to rededicate your life to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, this is a beautiful opportunity for you to do so. I will say the prayer and you will repeat it after me like you meant it. Oh Lord God, I come to you in the name of Jesus Christ. I believe with all my heart in Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. I believe he died for me and God raised him from the dead. I believe he is alive today. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is the Lord of my life from this day. Through him and in his name, I have eternal life. I'm born again. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. I'm now a child of God. Hallelujah. Congratulations. If you say that prayer with me, you are now a child of the living God. I will be praying for you. Do not hesitate to send me an email. I'll be looking forward to reading from you. God bless you.